Hello students of 9th standard, we have started the lesson that is nothing but lesson number 7th, energy flow in an ecosystem. This is the lesson from your section B part. Now in this lecture, before this lecture or in the last lecture, we have seen what are, you can say, producers. Those who produce the food, they are called as the producers. Those who consume the food, they are called as the consumers. The consumers may be primary consumers, secondary consumers, they may be tertiary consumers, or you can say the apex consumers. So this way there will be the consumers. Then we have seen about the decomposers also. Decomposers are the organisms or which depend upon the, you can say, dead bodies. So these are called as the decomposers. So we have seen yesterday these all things. In that we have also seen about the primary consumers. Primary consumers are eaten by the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers are eaten by the tertiary consumers. Tertiary consumers are eaten by the apex consumers. The apex consumers are, you can say, one of the top consumers here. The apex consumer are not eaten by any, you can say, any organism. They are only decomposed by the microbes. This yesterday we have seen. In yesterday's lecture, we have also seen what is food chain. I have shown you only the chain. In that I have shown you from sun, taking the sun rays, or by the process of the photosynthesis, the plants prepare their food and we call them as the autotrophs. This I have told you. The plants, or you can say, depending upon the plants, the grasshoppers eats the plants, you can say, or eat the food, whichever is prepared by the, you can say, plants, or the fruits, or the flowers, or any other things, parts of the, you can say, plants are eaten by the grasshopper. The grasshopper is eaten by the, you can say, frog. The frog is eaten by the snake. The snake is eaten by the eagle. Eagle is nothing but a one of the, you can say here, last consumer, because no one is going to kill the, you can say, eagle. But after decomposing, what happens? The decomposer may eat this eagle, or they may feed on this eagle, and they may get mixed into the soil, and further this soil is, you can say, used by the plants. This is nothing but a one of the food chain that we have seen. Now, yesterday I have also told you that there is a relation between a food chain and food weight. So, whenever you are seeing a particular food chain, what does the food chain tells you? That there are 3 to 4, or you can say more links are there, in which the animals are depending on one another for eating, or for, you can say, for their food purpose. But here the animals are also dependent on other animals for their food, not only for only on grass, or you can say not only on only insects. They are also dependent on other animals. So they are called, they are, this, you can say, interconnection is called as a food web. So here we are going to see this interrelation between the food chain and food web. So what is that? See here, a definite sequence in interaction. What is that? This is nothing but a definite sequence between producers, consumers, saprophytes. This is called as a food chain. Suppose there is a particular sequence between the, you can say, producers, or you can say consumers, saprophytes, then we may call it as a food chain. Each food chain consist of 4 to 5 or more than that links. Suppose here a insect feeds upon her leaves. That means what here? Here plants are producers. That means they are producing the food. But the insect feeds on the leaves. That means here the insect becomes the consumer. But at the same time, this insect is the prey. Is the prey for the various animals like frog. That means insect himself is not eating the plants, but again it will be in other action, it will be the prey of the frog. Here, even though this insect is nothing but a herbivorous, this herbivorous is eaten by a carnivorous, that is nothing but a frog. Frog is a carnivorous. Why it is called as a carnivorous? Because it is nothing but a flesh eater. Therefore, we call the frog as a carnivorous. Then, which is again a prey of a snake? This frog is a prey of a snake. Now here, both of these are nothing but the carnivorous animals. Snake is the prey of the eagle, or you can say kite. Now here also both are nothing but the carnivorous. That means the carnivorous feeds on carnivorous only. You may get that, you can say, link also. In the similar way, rabbits are the prey of the wild cat. Rabbits are the prey of the wild cat. And jackals, which are the prey of the lions. So, in this, we may see that interdependence of one another is there. An ecosystem consists of many such food chains which are interconnected at various levels, forming an intricate web. That means they are interconnected between each another, and they are forming a, you can say, one linear chain which consists of a various animals. They are dependent on one another. This kind of an intricate network, or this type of a network, is called as the food web.
Start.
See here, the next point is we are going to see about the energy. What is meant by the energy? Now here, whenever the producers means here plants, they are producing the food. So this food is eaten by the, you can say, consumers. Then the consumers are again eaten by the, you can say, decomposers. This way the chain is there. So first, what happens whenever the, you can say, food chain goes from one step to the another step? There is a, you can say, formation of energy. That means what? See here, whenever the producers produce the food, that means here the plants, they produce the food. This food is eaten by the grasshopper, that means it gets some amount of energy there. But to do its all activities, the grasshopper uses some amount of energy. That means it is given out in the form of a heat, you can say. Then this remaining energy is transferred to the next level. This way it is there. So what does this tells us? We are going to see. That point is nothing but energy transfer from plants to the apex consumers. Now here, what are plants? Plants are nothing but the producers. And who are apex consumers? Apex consumers are the consumers who are not eaten by anybody. Then, or who are not the prey of anybody. Then see here, all the plants in the ecosystem are producers. So whichever the plant may be, the plant may be a very small plant, or the plant may be a very tall plant, these all are nothing but the, you can say, they are producers. These plants store some of this solar energy. So whatever they are getting the energy from the sun, and this energy is called as a solar energy. Solar energy is in the form of the food. That is nothing but this energy, whichever is there, is stored in, you can say, are passed from one tropic level to the next tropic level. That means here energy is passed from plants to the, you can say, grasshopper, from grasshopper to the, you can say, the frogs, from frogs to the snakes, from snakes to the eagles, and from eagles to the decomposers. This way the energy is passed. See, when energy flows from one tropic level to the next, what happens there? Some of the energy is lost. Why this is told that the sum of the energy is lost? Because even if it gets the energy from the previous, you can say, level, or previous animal, So what happens to do its various activities? That means, for example, I'm telling here, we are getting the energy from the plants, or we are using the plant products as our food. But this energy we are using in some of the activities, doing some of the activities. Similarly here, some energy is lost as the heat at each step. Means at each step, this energy is lost. And that means at each tropic level, this heat energy is lost. And it is lost in the form of the, you can say, heat. Apex consumers occupy the last position in the, you can say, tropic level. So whenever you are seeing the tropic level diagram, in that you may find that the apex consumers are occupying the last position. Why they are at the last position? Because they are not hunted by anybody. No one is there to kill that apex consumers, or no one is there to eat that apex consumers. So this is nothing but a, you can say, apex consumers occupy the last position in the tropic level. So the amount of energy decreases during transfer from plants to the apex consumers. So what you are seeing this? See here, why this is told? That amount of energy is decreased during transfer from plants to the apex consumer. Because plants here acts as a producers. They are eaten by the primary consumers. Then secondary, primary consumers are eaten by the secondary consumers. Secondary consumers are eaten by the tertiary consumers. Tertiary consumers are eaten by the apex consumers. And no one is there to eat the apex consumers. So this is the energy pyramid here. What does this pyramid tells us? See here, at the, you can say, at the lowest level, you are finding the producers, then are the herbivores, then are the carnivores, then are the omnivores. So to whom do you call the producers? Producers are nothing but the, you can say, plants. Those who produce, they are called as the producers. Those who produce the food, they are called as the producers. Now, those who are depending on the plants, they are called as the herbivores. And those who are depending on herbivores, they are called as the carnivores. And those who depend on both herbivores and carnivores are called as the omnivores. So, carnivores are the flesh eaters. Omnivores are both grass and flesh eaters. So, whenever you see the tropic level here, these are nothing but a plant, or you can say produce level. Then the herbivores is the first tropic level. Then carnivores is the second tropic level. And omnivores is the third tropic level. In today's lecture, we have seen about the energy, the food chain, the food web, and the tropic levels. The next point we will see in next lecture.